Hi everyone, welcome you all. In this video, I'm going to show you how we can work with the text box or input box using robot framework. So normally when you see the input boxes in your web pages, we do certain actions like visibility status we can check and whether the text box is enabled or not. And we can also provide some value or input some value into it. And finally, we can also clear that value, right? So these are the operations we can normally we do on text boxes or input boxes. Now, in this video, I'm going to show you how we can perform these actions on input box or text box. And apart from this, I will also show you how we can verify the titles of the page. Now, let's get started. So here I have my PyCharm and this project we already created in the previous video. So here under test cases directory, I'm going to create a new test case, that is new file. This is a robot file. So here I'm naming it as inputbox.robot. Okay, then click on OK. Now I just created one robot file. So here first we need to add different sections. So as I discussed earlier, so we need to have setting section where we need to specify the libraries and variable section and then test cases and then keyword. So all the four sections we need to write. So the first one is the settings. So let me write settings. So these are the settings. That's the first thing. The next section is variables. So the next section is variables. So we need to have only 3 stars. And after that, we need to have test cases. This is the one more section. And the next one is, let me write properly, star, or you can say directly, test cases. Star. Okay, so this is the test cases. Now this is one more section. And after that, we need to have keyword section. So let me just write keyword section. Okay, now we have created 4 sections. Under settings, we need to write a reference library. So by using a library keyword, so library. Now here I'm going to use a Selenium library. So in this particular test case, I'll say Selenium library. Selenium library, okay. So this is a library I have imported and referenced. Now currently I will define 2 variables. One is the browser name and the URL of application. So I'll create 2 variables here. So how to create a variable in robot framework is dollar in the curly braces. Here we need to say, let's say browser and the one tab and the name of the browser, I'll say Chrome. And this Chrome driver we already copied in the Python scripts folder. Okay, that I have shown earlier video. And then here we need to specify the complete path of your Chrome driver. Okay, and now the next one is URL variable. So let's say dollar and the curly brace. Then here say URL and one tab space. And here I'm going to use one application called this one. This is a URL of application. So let me also show you this application. If I go here and this is my application. So in this application, I can see how I'll just click on the login. And after clicking on the login, I can see one text box. So I just try to enter some value here. And I also I can verify something here. Okay. So now this is the URL of my application. So these are the 2 variables I have defined under variable section. So these variables I will use inside the test cases. Now come to the test cases section. So here we need to provide some name of the test case. Okay, so here I will say testing input box. So testing input box. So this is my test case name I give it. So testing input box. This is the name of the test. So under this, we need to write all the keywords. So the first keyword should be, we need to open the browser. So for that, we have a keyword called open browser. As soon as you have written the statement, automatically this will pop up, auto suggestions will come. So open browser, and here which browser we need to use. So this is a browser and this is a URL. So first we need to use this particular URL, and that URL should be used open in this particular browser. One tab space and give that particular browser. So what this statement will do is, this particular keyword will open the browser, Chrome browser, on this it will open this URL. And after that, I will maximize this window. To maximize the window, simply maximize browser window. So this command or keyword will maximize your window. And as soon as I have done this, I want to verify the title of the page. So as soon as I click on this, it will open my page. Now I need to verify this title of the page, what exactly title it is. But we need to know before what exactly expected title. If I just go and inspect here in this particular page, so under header tag, we can see the title of the page. So this is our expected title. So I want to verify this title of the page is this one or not. So we have one more keyword here. to verify the title of the page, especially in the robot framework. It is very straightforward. Let's say title should be and specify the title, whatever you are expecting. And don't put any double quotations or single quotations. So directly just straightforward, title should be. And similarly, we have a title should not be. The negative condition is also there. Okay, suppose if I say title should be, and I think title should not be there, but for other elements, we have a negative condition also. Okay, should be and should not be. So we'll see that. So title should be this one. So this is the title I am expecting from this particular page. Now, after that, I need to click on this login link. So I need to just click on this login link on this particular page. How to click on the link? Let's inspect this element. Now, basically, this is the link, right? So login is my link. Or you can also capture the X path of this link. Now I want to click on this link. So I can just use one of the method called click link directly and specify the locator of this link. So this is the X path normally. So I'll say X path colon. This is a syntax in robot framework. So these are all locators. Okay. Based on the locate, X path is one of the locator of the element, like ID, name, X path, CSS selector, class name, tag, all these kinds of locators we can use it. So this will perform click on login link. So once you click on the login link, then it will open up this particular window. Now I need to perform certain validations on this particular email text box. So what are those validations? So the first validation, I will verify the visibility status, that text box is visible or not, then enable or not, and then we'll provide some value. After that, I'll clear that value. Okay. And we also verify the title of the page, which is already done as soon as the page is launched. Now let us see these four actions, how we can perform: visibility status, enable status, provide the value, and then clear the value. So the first one is visibility. So before doing all these actions, first of all, I will capture this element, or I'll store this locator in some variable. And whenever I'm referring that element, I will use that particular variable. So what I'm saying here is, here itself, I will create one variable. Let's say dollar in the curly braces, in double quotations, let's say first name. And what is that field here? That is email, right? So let me just put email here. Email underscore txt. Okay, this is email underscore text box. So for this, I'm just going to capture that element, whatever email we have. And then I will store that into some variable. And then whenever you perform certain actions on this, I will refer that variable instead of writing the same code again and again. So I've just created one variable here. Now here we have a keyword called set variable, right? In the robot framework, we have a command called set variable. So this variable we have created, inside this, I will set some value. What is that value? Is that X path of this particular element. Now inspect this element. And if you have ID or some other property, that's fine. So I can just take it. So let's say ID is there. Let me just capture the email ID. And here, set variable. Okay, set variable. And here ID is this one. So what I'm saying here is this one, this ID value, I'm storing into this particular variable. So which is referring that particular element. Okay, now I'm going to use this variable as a web element to perform other actions. So now I'll perform all the actions. First of all, first that element is visible or not, that I need to verify. So for that, we have a straightforward keyword is available. So direct element should be visible. That's our expectation. Element should be visible. Which element? This particular element that we need to specify. And similarly, I need to verify that element is enabled or not. Similarly, we have a direct option, element should be visible. So enabled. So enabled, which element? The same element. So after verification of these two, so element should be visible, and also we have a negative condition. So element should be visible, should be enabled, right? So here also we have a should not be visible. Okay, should not be disabled. So all other options also there. Should be visible, should not be visible. Similarly, should be enabled, should not be enabled. So negative operations also we can perform here. So this is another important option we have. So element should be visible. Which element we are expecting, it will verify. And if the element is visible, then this will pass or else fail. And the element should be enabled. So I'm expecting enable status. If it is not enabled, this will also fail. And after that, I'll try to provide some value into the input box. So again, on the same element, I need to provide the value. How we can pass a value? We have another keyword called input text. So input text on which element we need to pass? This particular element, we need to pass the input text. And what's the value we need to pass? That we have to specify. Here I'll say John David at the rate gmail.com. Some value I'm specified here. So some value I have specified. So in this element, I'm passing this value. So after that, I will wait for some time and then I clear that value. So how we can wait? I can just add some sleep here. Let's wait for 5 seconds. And then after that, I want to clear this name on the same field. So we have a command called clear element directly. So clear element. So which element we need to clear? Clear, not element, clear element text. So I'll say clear element text. So which element we need to clear? This particular element. So wherever we have provided email ID, I'm also clearing the same element. So after that, again, I will wait for a few more seconds. Let's say 3 seconds. And after that, I close the browser. So I'll just say close browser. So this is how we can do certain validations on input boxes. So first I open the browser and then maximize the window. Then I verify the title by using title should be keyword. And then I click on the login link and then I got user email and password fields. Now email address, email field I have verified here. First I have stored that email into some variable, or if I don't want to store that into this variable, you need to write this one in every time, in every place. Okay, instead of doing that, I store that into some variable. Now I'm verifying that whether it is visible or not, enabled or not, and then I'm providing some value. And then after that, after clearing this value, after some time, I'm clearing this text field and then I'm closing the browser. So this is how we need to perform certain operations on input boxes. Now let's execute it. If you want to execute this test case, we need to run only through terminal. So PyChamp is provided a terminal at the bottom. Just if you click on the terminal, you will get the terminal here. Now we need to first provide a keyword called robot. This is a command robot, and where your test is created under test cases directly. So go to test cases slash my test name is input box dot robot. So that I need to specify input box dot robot. Now let's execute. So once you run this, now it is started my browser. Started my browser. Now open the URL, maximize this window. Now you can see it is entered the value. After some time, it will clear that value. Yes, now everything is clear and then browser also will be closed. Now we can see what are all pass and failure. Now you can see there are no failures because those verification points got passed, right? So now I haven't get any failure. So because those verification points, both the verifications like these two, what are they? So title should be, and then element should be visible, element shouldn't be enabled. So these are passed so that my test cases got passed. And similarly, if you want to verify the negative condition, you can simply say instead of these two, you can also write not visible. So and let me comment this. Instead of this, you can say element should be element. Let's say element. Should be visible or should not be visible. So the again, I'll put same element. So this is a negative condition. So currently element is visible so that it will get failed. Okay. Now let's execute again one more time. Go to console window, run this test once again. Now again, it launches the browser, opening this URL. So now my test got, my test will fail now. I have given the negative condition. Right. So now we can just go and see the PyCharm. All right, so now just see here, failure. So ID should not be visible, but it is saying, right? So it is visible, but why I'm expecting it should not be visible. So that's the reason here itself, it got failure and rest of the code is not continued. So this is also, we can verify the negative as well as positive conditions, right? So this is how we can work with the text box or input. In the next video, I will show you few more elements. So thanks for watching this video, guys.